Ms. Peggy Lim, Assistant Chief Executive, SIM Global Education. Mr. Haresh Sapnani, Founder and CEO, Spice Private Limited. Distinguished guests, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, a very good afternoon and welcome to the Diploma Graduation Ceremony. My name is Kelly and I will be your Master of Ceremony. Today is a special occasion and we would like to extend our heartiest congratulations to the 191 graduates who will be receiving their diplomas. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure now to invite Dr. Timothy Chan, Director, Academic Division, SIM Global Education, to deliver the welcome address. Dr. Timothy Chan, please.
Ms. Peggy Lim, Assistant Chief Executive, SIM Global Education. Mr. Haresh Sapnani, Founder and CEO, Spice Private Limited. Distinguished guests, graduates, ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. My heartiest congratulations to all of our graduates on this special day. Your graduation is indeed an important milestone. It not only marks the end of one chapter of your learning journey, it also signifies the beginning of another chapter, be it the start of a degree education or the pursuit of a new career. I know that the majority of you are continuing your learning journey through a university education here in SIM or elsewhere. As you continue to develop your talents, I would like to share with you some comments from a recently published research report by the Chartered Institute of Personnel and Development entitled The Future of Talents in Singapore 2030. Here are some of the quotes from the expert panels of the research about talents. Performance today is a must. The differentiator is the ability to deliver in the future. Hence, the need to learn, evolve, and adapt as the future unfolds. Talent is not about the ability to just deliver. It is more about the capacity and the capability to create value. Hence, innovativeness and strategic thinking are more important. It is also about the ability to communicate ideas to people. I do not think that some people are not talented. There are individuals who haven't found the area in which their particular skills would be valuable. So, experts view talented people as those who have the ability to learn, evolve, and adapt with innovative mind and strategic thinking skills. Talented people are also people who are able to engage others and understand problems from multiple perspectives. Evidently, talent in the work context is considered to be a quality that can be developed, not merely an innate inborn ability. While one is not a talent in one particular field, one can be a talent in another. So I believe each one of us has the capacity and capability to develop to be a talented person in our own chosen area, contributing to the betterment of our society. And I hope that our education programs have helped you acquire a passion for learning and develop your unique identity as a talent. As you reflect on your learning journey, I hope that you will look back with gratitude and remember to show your appreciation to your loved ones, friends, and lecturers, to let them know that this day would not have been possible without them. To close, I wish you all the best and congratulations again. Thank you. Now, I would like to introduce you our guest speaker. We are very happy to have with us today one of our SIM Global Education alumni, Mr. Harish Sabani, founder and CEO of Spice Private Limited. Mr. Harish graduated from the IMI, International Hotel Management Institute, Switzerland, with the Bachelor of Arts in European Culinary Management in 2008. He managed a full-service consultancy firm that specializes in developing concept restaurants with focus on the halal industry. He managed a team of over 200 employees with a turnover of over Singapore $18 million in this year. It is now my pleasure to invite Mr. Harish to address us. Mr. Harish, please.
Good afternoon, Ms. Peggy Lim, Assistant Chief Executive, SIM Global Education, distinguished guests, graduates, ladies and gentlemen. I would firstly like to congratulate all the graduates on your accomplishments, and by reaching such a monumental milestone in your life, it is indeed an honor for me to be here to bear witness to such a happy occasion. The reality is that upon reaching this milestone, you are now faced with a crucial question that will have a huge impact on your future. The question is, what's next? What's next for you? Some of you are already considering pursuing a degree, while others are already planning to join the workforce to either gain some experience or attain some form of financial stability, you know, just get some cash. There might be even some of you who are also considering embarking on the entrepreneurial route and starting your own business. I'm here today to just give you some insight on what you should consider when making your decision. The main point that I would like to encourage all of you to consider when making a decision would be ownership. You need to own the choices that you make, as it will dictate what happens to you in the most crucial part of your career. The decisions that you make now will determine the next 5 to 10 years of your lives. And whoever you become during this period will shape the rest of your life. Owning the choices means being accountable for the results and knowing that everything that happens in my life is because I created it. While it's valuable to get advice and look at alternatives, you need to stay true to who you are and go with what you're passionate about. Because passion is what is the only thing, in fact, that will sustain you in your career and give you the success that you desire. My entrepreneurial journey started 15 years ago, when I pitched a new concept, to the soon-to-be-open Esplanade. This was before they even started. I was very excited about it. You know, I put in a lot of effort into the proposal, but I was rejected. I was quite disappointed because it was a very good proposal. And that set me on the path to where I am today. My first real business started in 2001 when I set up a hawker stall. I had a diploma in accounting and finance, but I decided to set up a hawker stall in a coffee shop, selling roti johns, burgers, kebabs, fish and chips. I employed two elderly ladies and one illegal worker from Myanmar. I didn't know he was illegal at the time. It was an extremely rough and challenging journey, but without regrets. I made wrong decisions, and I did some crazy things. But I'm happy where I am today. And today we have 3 locations, over 200 employees, annual revenue, 18 million, and we are constantly expanding. We are constantly growing. We are constantly developing. The single most important element that has sustained me throughout this entire journey has been passion. Passion for what I believe in and passion for what I'm creating. Entrepreneurship is a journey. It's a lifelong commitment, longer than marriage. It's a lifelong commitment to a singular cause. It's a lonely journey at times. I say lonely because to some extent, nobody truly understands what you're going through. You know, it's sometimes you just feel like nobody understands you. But it's usually rewarding. When I say rewarding, I don't mean in the sense of financial success. You know, that's a byproduct of a successful business. When I say rewarding, I mean in the sense of creating value that impacts the lives of others. So what does it take to be an entrepreneur? What does it take? You need one of these three things. You need to be either extremely rich. Anybody very rich here? No? Okay. Or you need to be extremely brilliant. I'm talking about Caltech, Oxford, Harvard, you know, MIT, Princeton. Or you need to be extremely passionate. Passion goes a long way. If you're not one of these three things, I wouldn't recommend. Entrepreneurs need to have a strong sense of what people really want. You need to be able to connect with what is most important to people, human beings, which is emotions. This involves having an intuitive perspective into people around you and understanding what drives emotions. The most successful companies do precisely that. My favorites, Apple, Facebook, you know, even Instagram, Snapchat, it's all about emotions, you know. The challenges that I faced as a business owner was beyond what I imagined. It was definitely beyond what I was prepared for. I struggled. I feared that I was not good enough, you know, to bring the company forward. But each business has its own unique challenges. If you decide to go on the entrepreneur route, you will face your own unique challenges. But most businesses fail because they are overly concerned and bogged down by problems that they are facing, you know, logistical problems or, you know, issues like that. Because it brings them away from focusing on their product or their service. So how do you overcome this? You know, again, passion. Because passion and focusing on your product is what will get you there. And ensuring that customers get the satisfaction that they want, that they desire from your product or from your service. Those who are focused on financial rewards or getting rich through the entrepreneurial route, you won't be successful. Because focusing on financial rewards, focusing on the money, will distract you from the most important element of your business, which is your product. It just takes you away from focusing on your product and your service, or your service. So the question, if you decide to go on an entrepreneurial route, is how do you get started? How do you get started? The most practical steps in starting your own business is to first to gain experience. I mean, experience, it's crucial, you know. If you decide, whichever industry that you decide, you know, find the best possible company that you can work in and join the company and learn how they do things, you know. Get that experience. And you will realize that building a CV, a credible CV, will be very important when you decide to raise funds for your venture. Another option is Platform E, which is actually an SIM initiative. Okay, SIM has just announced the setting up of an entrepreneurship center to develop future entrepreneurs and encourage business startups. Platform E will adopt a unique approach in plugging a gap in the market of entrepreneurship programs, incubators, and accelerators. Platform E is a comprehensive platform that integrates all the important components essential to a startup success: training and equipping entrepreneurs, incubating of business ideas, and acceleration of go-to-market startups, all supported by a robust ecosystem of co-working space and professional corporate services, and a wide network of coaches, mentors, peers, and most importantly, investors. In short, Platform E offers a one-stop learning, incubator, and accelerator program. The common misperception about entrepreneurship is that it is about hitting it big with one enterprising idea. The reality is that entrepreneurship is a lifelong journey of many great ideas. Platform E believes that any good entrepreneurship program must allow the entrepreneur to discover himself and develop the business and leadership skills that he needs. It must also inculcate in him the fortitude to take on and sustain this exciting and challenging journey. Under Platform E, a 12-month entrepreneurship track is offered to aspiring entrepreneurs like yourselves. Under this program, you will learn and work on your startup. And at the same time, you will do hands-on practical work and internship that will help you develop your business ideas and start your own business. This will be guided by learning coaches and mentors who are experienced and successful entrepreneurs themselves. You will also benefit from the ecosystem of peers, peer communities, industry experts, and investors, and have access to the co-working space and support of corporate services. At the end of the 12-month track, you will expect to graduate with a business startup. Most importantly, you would have acquired the knowledge and skills needed to run your own business, or even join an organization as an entrepreneur, if you choose. I would like to end by stressing that whatever path that you take in your life, take ownership of it, because it's your life, and let your passion sustain you in your journey and in your success. With this, I wish you all the best. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Haresh. We will now begin the presentation of diplomas. I shall now invite Ms. Peggy Lim, Assistant Chief Executive, SIM Global Education, to present the diplomas. Ms. Lim, I present to you the graduates from the Diploma in Accounting.
Wu Jiawen Rachel. Hans Setiawan. Lian Jingguo. Lim Sing Yi Desiree. Hang Ying Jie. Qiu Jun Yi. Sung Kenrick. Wu Tai Han. Yao Kok Ken.
For the Diploma in Banking and Finance, the graduates are
Adrian Ho Kyu Chong, Chiu Wei Wen Fabian, Ganesh Nadrajan, Lai Pao Ling, Lim Jian Hong, Miet Terafi Luen, Tan Shi In. Tay Wei Lin. Vincent Chandra Vijaya. Wong Wenhui.
For the Diploma in International Business, the graduates are
Eddie Quek, Alec Teo Jun Kai, Chi Li Xuan Justin. Galen Ku Yu Li. Su Miet Thi Rizor. Jefferson Wang So. Lim Shi Chun. Lim Ying Qi. Mohammed Nu Faiz. Han Xiao Min. Wong Hui Zhen. Li Yi.
For the Diploma in Management Studies, 49 intake, the graduates are
Angelina Chiu Jia Hui, Cesario Prayogo Sutoyo. Shireen Anditya. Chia Cheng Ying Eugene. Chu Le Ting. Dai Xin. Denzel Wilson Kosastra. Elisa Suryani Harto. Azana Favin Binti Habib Rahman. Belda Ridwan. Francisca Simsia. Gabriella Aurelia. Gabby Cynthia Gobaja. Ya Ki Xiang. Heinrich. Wang Xiaojun. Jaren Ho Chi Kang. Jessica Ong Li Ping. Jocelyn Katerina Tanujaya. Gao Mian Wu. Kennedy. Ko Jia Wei Jasper. Ko Shi Sheng. Hu Si Jia. Guo Quan Yi. Jia Niu Tin. Joe Kitty. Levy Josephine. Lo Li Xuan. Lo Wei Jie. Marine Geska Aditya. Maverick Lim Jun Yu. Melva Lim. Moni Tuta. Adolfo Arcane Sean Mallory. Natasha Jovita. Ong Wei Qin. Osika Silviana. Mary Tan Sien Kim. Hua Jia Hong. Yu Xin Ji. Hua Jun Leong. Roderick Carleton Telicardi. Roy Nelson Nila Mogan. Satish Kumar Supermanyam. Shireen Vijaya. Sim Fam Jia Sin. Sutrisno. Sylvester Xia Jun Jie. Tan Ze Yi. Tanda Wu. Vivi Lenita. Wang Fei Yan. William Chai Rudin. Wilson Malvern. Wong Yen Ting. Yedena Min Ao. Ye Kong Bala. Yo Zong Ju. Yomelia Christine. Zhang Yuxiang Tobias. Zhang Zhecheng. Zhang Zhemin. Zhou Ying-wen. Xiao Wei Kai. Zhu Bieta.
For the Diploma in Management Studies, 50th intake, the graduates are
Aisha Kennelly. Ang Tri Ling Grace. Bu Jia Hui. Cai Pei Lin. Ang Cheong En. Chang Mei-Yen Grace. Charles Hasono. Chen Xiaochong. Jervie Wong Kaysi. Jiang Yiling. Chin Ka Hui. Chua Yuying Jane. Dai Tai Min. Dermawan Susanto. Yo Xiao Yang. Edward Wijono. Yi Shui Sin Pio. Ellie Chong Yi Lee. Eunice Tan Mei Ru. Wu Jia Wen. Franciscus Vincentius Kartika. Wu Pei Chi. Gary Lo Jue Yang. Guo Qi Xian. Guo Chu Ming. Gurkiran Kaur. Pei Te Za To. Ping Fu Shun Sandy. Janice Sim Jia Yi. Jennifer Lai. Jeremy Luke Vignesh Devan. Jonathan Pang Jun Jie. Jocelyn Anthony. Kenny. Kin Nin Pew. Chris Iden Garu. Kong Chai Hui. Lau Ali. Li Zhixin. Leong Wai Kit. Liang Ying Qian. Lim Shi Qing. Liao Yi Chun. Lui Ka He. Lui Kin Fong. Madi Miu Min. Mai Hai Chuan. Mark Kai Yi. Maria Francisca Solomon. Matilda Tan Tie Un. Melina Irwan. Miet Dura Zor. Eng Jintin. Eng Yiting. Eng Yuru Adele. Nguyen Tan Phuc. Nicole Hong Mei Ting. O Wei Lun. Peter Hutomo Riadi. Reina Camelia Liwijaja. Richard. Richie. Ricky Chandra. Rudy Murianto. Ryan Chia Li Ming. Sophia Ang Si Qi. Stephanie Chin. Tadina Rao Elvin Sison. Tan En Li. Tan Le En. Tan Si Yun. Tan Wei Lin. Tan Kai Hui. Deza Aung Myo. Lam Ming Siang Dixon. Tin Ta Nui. Vincent Anga Jaja. Wang Tian Jiao. Wilson Yan Xun Tan. Wong Hui Yi Charmaine. Wong Jun Wei. Wong Ka Hing. Wu Si Ming. Yao Jia Yi.
Ladies and gentlemen, among the graduates today are some individuals who have excelled in their programs. Ms. Lim will now present special awards to these top graduates in recognition of their outstanding performance. From the Diploma in Accounting, winner of the Mapletree Silver Award, Lian Jing Guo. From the Diploma in Banking and Finance, winner of the Mapletree Gold Award, Chiu Wei Wen Fabian. From the Diploma in International Business, winner of the Mapletree Gold Award, Chi Li Xian Justin. From the Diploma in Management Studies, 49th intake, winner of the Mapletree Gold Award, Chia Cheng In Eugene. Winners of the Mapletree Silver Award, Jia Niu Tin. Natasha Jovita. Sylvester Xia Junjie. Winners of the Mapletree Bronze Award, Gabriela Aurelia. Hia Ki Xiang. Recipient of the Certificate of Commendation, Sutrino. From the Diploma in Management Studies, 50th intake, winner of the Mapletree Gold Award, Wu Si Ming. Winner of the Mapletree Silver Award,
Leong Wai Kit. Winners of the Maple Tree Bronze Award, Maria Francisca Solimin. Tan Si Yun. Recipients of the Certificate of Commendation, Chang Chong An. Franciscus Vincentus Katika. Gakirian Kaur. Tin Tha Nue. Thank you, Ms. Lim, for presenting the diplomas and awards. We would like to take this opportunity to thank Mapletree Investments for their sponsorship of the prizes under the Mapletree Academic Achievement Program. Once again, let us put our hands together and give our graduates and award winners a round of applause for their hard work and achievements. Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the ceremony. We thank you for celebrating this special occasion with us. Please join us for light refreshment on level 2. Thank you and have a pleasant evening ahead.